Welcome back to Every Day in His Presence. Okay, today we're going to do chapter 63 of the book of Psalm. But you go ahead and read the entire chapter. We're going to focus on verse 1 and 3 of this devotional. And the devotional reads as follows. Unfortunately, sin can prevent you from experiencing the communion you were created for. You may even be seeking comfort or significance from sources that cannot satiate your longings, such as possessions, prominence, or addictions, and I also may add fame, status, pride, and so forth. King David, the author of Psalm 63, understood this real well. He had everything a person could desire, but concluded that the only one who could genuinely satisfy his soul was God. Isn't that the truth? The same is true for you and me. The Father created you and me in His image so you could interact with Him in a profoundly meaningful way that would fulfill your deepest longings. Isn't that the truth? So I went ahead and read chapter 63, but I underlined in green because it's going to be an ongoing prayer as per the Bible Reading Journal Series versed color chart to acknowledge His promise. Reminds me of, you God are my God. Earnestly I seek you. I thirst for you. My whole being longs for you in a dry and parched land where there is no water. Verse 3, I underlined it in red because I like to maintain a grateful heart and embrace His love. Just remember, gratitude is the best antidote for discontentment. So because your love is better than life, my lips will glorify you, Lord. So I went ahead and I translated that same two verses in the NASB and the CSB. And the CSB translation says, God, you are my God. I eagerly seek you. I thirst for you. My body faints for you in a land that is dry and without water. My lips will glorify you because your faithful love is better than life. My reflection for the day based on those two verses, I made a note to remind myself, my soul will always thirst for His wisdom and inner peace. I cannot do it on my own strength. I need His favor. I need His grace and love. And these are much better than life, anything that life can offer me. Lord, help me step out in obedience today. I'll read your word, take time to meditate on day and night, and I'll seek you always, one day at a time. I like to repent my tendencies to be busy all the time. And I went ahead and counted my blessings, which we all know is the best antidote for discontentment. Pray specifically, and I went ahead, and you might want to write these down: Psalms 118 verse 28, chapter 42 verse 2, and chapter 84 verse 2. And in Psalms chapter 118 verse 28 reminds me, you are my God, and I will give you thanks. You are my God, and I will exalt you always. In Jesus' name we pray. Amen. So you all, we're going to meet at a later date, a later segment for another portion, devotional, and scripture on Every Day in His Presence. Thank you. Have a blessed day and talk soon.